I extend a warm welcome to the members of public in attendance and those watching on our webcast. I would like to remind all members to speak clearly into their microphones for the benefit of those watching at home. I would now like to call on my chaplain, Father Lucas, to say a prayer before the meeting. And could I invite councillors to stand, please?
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. God our Father, we pray that this new year may be a year of hope. Hope for our families, that they might receive the support they need in order to become more stable and happy. Hope that the world would wake up to the realities of climate change and do what needs to be done to save our planet. Hope that the world would become a more peaceful place for everyone to live in. Dear Lord, bless all those who govern. Bless our councillors gathered here in this meeting at the beginning of this new year. Give them wisdom to be able to read the signs of the times and work for the greater good of all God's people. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Right, I did notice that the leader of the council wanted to say something. Is that right, Councillor Hackett?
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Mr. Mayor, can I propose tonight, if I may, I'm sorry I haven't given it, can we take number three, please, first. Independent Remuneration Panel, please. And that we have, in light of, which we only had tonight, and in light of the amendments tonight, that we have a gym for 10 minutes.
Can I just ask the leader of the council, could you just clarify on the independent remuneration? Is that because some members will not be staying here because they have got a pecuniary interest in the local plan?
Yes, Mr. Mayor.
Okay. Are members agreed to that? Yeah?
Agreed.
Yeah, okay. Thank you very much. Right. Now I'm going to ask members to consider whether you have any disclosable, pecuniary or any other relevant interest in connection with any matters to be determined at this meeting, and if so, to declare it and state the nature of such interest. Right, Councillor Steve Pass.
Yes, Mr. Mayor, on item 3A, which is the local plan, as a non-executive director of the Gentle Living, which does have a development arm, it may be perceived that I have a prejudicial interest in it. So in terms of taking, I shall declare a prejudicial interest and take no part in either the debate or the voting.
Thank you, Councillor. Councillor Tony Jones.
Yes, thank you, Mr. Mayor. I'd like to declare an interest in item 3A as a director of the Growth Company. I will be needing the chamber when that debate takes place. Thank you.
Well, thank you. Councillor Lewis.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I'd like to declare a personal interest by virtue of the fact that I'm a trustee of a charity that owns land in Eastham.
Councillor Jeff Green.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I'll be declaring a prejudicial interest in item 3A, as I too am a non-exec director, actually chair of the Enterprise Development Committee of Magenta Living, and it's been indicated that might lead to a conflict of interest, so I'll declare a prejudicial interest.
Thank you. Councillor Tom Usher.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I've heard my recent
Mr. Mayor, I think it's something that the head of the board uses well, this is my professional work. I should have leave the shame for item 3A and take no part in that. So I'd like to make your vote.
Okay, thank you, councillors. No other declarations? Right, I have been notified of the following apologies. Councillor Chris Blakely, Councillor Martin McLaughlin, Councillor, any other councillors? Councillor Yvonne Nolan?
Yes.
Any other?
Yes.
No. No. Okay, thank you. Yes, Councillor Hack.
Can I just say that our thoughts on this side are with
thank you, Councillor Hack. Right, I will be adhering strictly to the time limits during this meeting. Please do not ask for more time, as I will have to refuse you. Can I also remind members that they are free to leave the chamber and take a comfort break when they wish, although they should aim to be present for any votes. Okay, now that we have changed the order of the agenda, I will now move on to 3B, and that's membership of the Independent Remuneration Panel, which is on pages 533 to 536. Right, we're asking, the council meeting is asked to appoint the people listed in the report to the Independent Remuneration Panel for a period of 4 years. I call on Councillor Tony Cox to move the recommendations detailed in the summons.
So moved, Mr. Mayor.
I call on Councillor Hackett to second.
Second, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you. Councillor Cox, you now have 5 minutes to speak to your motion.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I will be uncharacteristic in the meeting. Due to the ongoing governance review, it was decided that this was a good opportunity to refresh the Independent Remuneration Panel, mainly in the interest of maintaining the public perception of the independence of that said panel. The participants have been here for some years before, probably longer than is advised, and this is a good line in the sand and a good opportunity to refresh the panel. I'd like to thank the outgoing panel for all of their work over the years and welcome the incoming panel. Big thanks as well to Vicky Shaw and Steve Fox for the work in actually finding the new members, and we look forward to hearing their comments over the next couple of months.
Thank you, Councillor Cox. Are there any speakers who wish to speak on that? No? Right, Councillor Hackett, you now have 3 minutes to speak to the motion. The second.
Just very briefly, Mr. Mayor, given that we are moving over to a new governance model, it's also vital, of course, as Councillor Cox has said, that we look at our allowances. That was agreed at the working group over this last number of months. Because it's a new environment we're entering after May. Big, big changes. And we thought it was important to reflect that the panel should change and reflect that as well. I think also the panel needs some of the comparable local authorities as well while it's deliberating and receiving evidence, which I'm sure it will. I'm supportive of the new panel membership whose makeup reflects Wirral's diverse community, and they have a big job of work, of course, going forward as we move into the new committee system, and I ask Council to support the recommendation. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Councillor Cox, you have now 3 minutes if you wish to continue.
I'll pass on that, Mr. Mayor, if it's necessary.
Okay, thank you. Right, there's no further comments. Is that agreed?
Agreed.
Do you need to go up to that time? No, just unanimous. Okay, thank you. Okay, we go back to the start the main item. So I'll wait till some people. people leave the chamber. Okay. Right, can we